My day is very well. Very well and so stressing,
Okay.
maybe.
Hey, do you celebrate Children's Day in your school?
Yes, but solo
Only?
primer y segundo ciclo.
Okay.
Only
Only juniors.
Yes, y my grade so play soccer
Wow,
and play basketball, football.
okay, nice, pero so happy Children's Day, okay?
Thank you.
Excellent, nice, thank you. Let's see. Hi, Nayeli, welcome.
Good evening, teacher.
Hey, Nayeli, how are you? I remember you were in the hospital last week, right?
Yeah, teacher.
So, how do you feel now? Much better?
Yes, more better.
Okay, nice. That's nice. So, do you go to school today?
No, I didn't go to school today. And well,
Yeah, you got a
no,
celebration,
I
right? No.
didn't. No, but tomorrow I go.
Okay, you have to. Okay, that's nice. I'm so happy to have you again, okay? Yeah, I'm so happy. Let's see.
Thank you, teacher.
Nice, perfect. Hi, Aide, welcome.
Hi, teacher. I'm doing well, thank you.
Excellent, so nice. Hey, Aide, one question. Do you
Okay.
like to read? Or do you prefer to listening to music, or do you prefer to watching TV? Choose one option. Read,
I
listening to
prefer two
music,
options.
or watching movies. Oh, excuse me, watching television.
I prefer two options. I read and listening to music.
Okay, perfect. So how many hours do you spend on reading? 1 hour, 2 hours, 30 minutes?
Aproximadamente 2 hours.
Okay, repeat after me. Around.
Around 2 hours.
Around 2 hours. Excellent. So today we're gonna start with one of the, well, as you know, my dearest students, as you know, we have four skills in English. The first one is listening. The second one is speaking. The third one is reading. And the last one is writing. In that order is the order that you have to practice. Usted no puede comenzar a escribir en inglés si no sabe hablarlo. Usted no puede comenzar a leer un libro si no sabe entender una conversación básica. Entonces, todo es en orden. So the first one is listening, the second one is speaking, the third one is reading, and the last one is writing. So today, I'm going to show you some different ways to read in English. I'm very sure, for example, hi Ivan, welcome. Could you please open your microphone?
Bien, teacher.
Ivan, do you consider your family? Tell me about your family. You have mom, dad, brothers. Tell me about your family first, please.
Well, in my family are my dad, my mom, and I have three sisters.
Older or younger?
And, one under and two younger. I'm the middle.
You're the middle one. Okay. So,
Yes.
in your family, do you have the culture to read?
Yes. Some, well, one of my sisters, yes. He take her time for read sometimes.
All right. What about you?
Yes. Sometimes, well, sometimes in English and other times in Spanish, but I try to take my time to read something,
All
a
right,
book
perfect.
or article.
All right, perfect. Thank you, Mr. So nice as usual. Yes, I have the question to Mr. Ivan because Well, according to my experience, maybe we don't have the culture to read. And right now, the technology is catching up our attention at all. So, but today I have three levels. No, I have four levels. So let's start with the first one. Look at how to read and interpret at the same time. I have four levels at reading. I got basic A1, A2. I got basic intermediate B1 and B2. So there are many ways to read, okay? There are many ways to read, but the most important is you have to enjoy it. For example, if you give to me a book that the book is about medicine, maybe, well, maybe not, I'm very sure I will get worried or I will get boring or I will start to crying because I do not understand nothing. But one of the recommendation is if you want to start to read something, you have to look for your favorite topics. For example, let me ask you, Renata, open your microphone, please.
Yes, teacher.
What's your favorite subject in the school? Science, math, language, English, computer, history.
My favorite subject is English.
Is English. Okay, thank you. Nayeli, what about you? What's your favorite subject in the school? Thank you, Nayeli. Are you ready to participate?
Yes,
Yeah,
teacher.
tell. Yeah, please pay attention, guys. Today I'm going to ask you to open your microphone many times, okay? So, Nayeli, what's your favorite subject in the school?
I don't have favorite teacher.
No
No.
Okay, well, that's nice. Used to be English. I know, used to be English. Aide, what about you? When you were studying, what was your favorite subject in the school?
My favorite subject are English and math because I love the math.
Hey, that's a tricky. ¿Saben qué? Eso es un poco extraño porque, for example, if I got a student who likes English, he doesn't like math. If I got a student who likes
Yes.
math, he doesn't like English, and you like both. Wow,
I
okay,
am
that's nice.
rara.
No, but you like both, yes, because it's so common to see
Yes.
someone that, teacher, I don't like math, but I love English. No, teacher, I hate English, but I love math. Okay, now let's see. I'm going to ask to Berito, could you please help me to read the information below? Please.
Okay, teacher, good evening. How to read and interpret it at the same time? Start with easy material. Read simple text such as children's books, short stories, or grab the reader appropriate to your level.
Appropriated to your level. That was I was explaining some seconds ago. Appropriate to your level. So let's start with level A1. What is level A1, teacher Gabriela? Level A1 is basic, simple, basic vocabulary, basic test, basic readings, basic synonyms, basic everything. So let's start with the first one. I'm going to read for you. Y aquí sí quiero que todos estén con un cuaderno a la mano para que me anoten, aunque sea dos, tres líneas, y me digan sus propias palabras de qué trata la lectura. Voy a leer, se los voy a leer y obviamente después voy a elegir algunos de ustedes para que los lean. Teacher, qué fácil es esa lectura. Este es A1. Vamos a ir por niveles. Ok, lee este A1.
Okay.
My favorite animal is a dog. Dogs are friendly and love to play. They have soft fur and wag their tails when they are happy. I like taking my dog to the park. We play a lot. And I throw a ball for him to catch. Dogs can be great friends because they are loyal and always by your side. I love my dog because he makes me happy and is always excited to see me. Okay, could you please let me see? Dennis, would you like to help me to read the text, please? Go ahead.
Okay,
Okay.
lo leo todo.
Yes, please.
Okay. My favorite animal is a dog. Dogs are friendly and love to play. They have soft fur and wag their tails when they are happy. I like taking my dog to the park. We play a lot. In I row, no sé si así.
I throw, yo lanzo, I throw.
I throw a ball for him to catch. Dogs can be great friends because they are loyal. No sé cómo
And
se.
always.
And always by your side. I love my dog because he makes me happy and is always
Excited
excited to see me, to
to see
see
me.
me.
Yes, perfect. Thank you, Denise. I need a volunteer, please. Who wants to help me to read again? Remember, one of the dynamic number one is explain the reading A1. Volunteer 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay. Who say me? Yeah, I need a volunteer. I didn't see who say me, teacher. Yeah, Nayeli,
For the read.
your camera is open. I don't have problem, Nayeli, if you want to get your cameras on, okay? But your camera is
Sorry.
open. No worries, my beauty. Okay, yes, I did. Thank you. Please read again.
My favorite animal is a dog. Dogs are friendly, love to play. They have soft fur and wash the when they are happy. I like taking my dog to the park. We play a lot, and I throw a ball for him to catch. Dogs can be great friendly because they are loyal and always by your side. I love my dog because he makes me happy, and he always excited to see me.
Okay, to see me. One more volunteer, please. Renata, would you like to try?
Okay.
Perfect. I'm gonna finish with you, and then please, you have to explain what's the test. Well, it's not a test. It's a paragraph. Yeah, it's a short paragraph. Okay, please, Renata, go ahead.
My favorite animal is a dog. Dogs are friendly and love to play. They have soft fur and wag their tails when they are happy. I like taking my dog to the park. We play a lot and I throw a ball for him to catch. Dogs can be great friends because they are loyal and always by your side. I love my dog because he makes me happy and it's always excited to see me.
To see me. Okay, thank you so much. Ivan, I have a question. Please, I need your help.
Yes, teacher.
There is a short quiz about your opinion. What would you like to do first? The presentation, I mean, explaining the text, or do the quiz first? Option one or option two? The quiz is option one and presenting is option two.
Well, presenting.
Presenting, okay. Let me see. Berito, what about you? Do the quiz or presenting?
Sorry, teacher.
What do you like to do now? Do the quiz about the paragraph or presenting?
The paragraph, teacher. The
Okay,
paragraph.
presenting the paragraph. Okay, presenting the paragraph and presenting the paragraph. Aide, what about you? Do the quiz or explain the paragraph?
Explained.
Explain the paragraph. Okay, so the majority won. So I'm going to give you 2 minutes, 2 minutitos. Cada uno me va a decir en sus propias palabras de qué trata este pequeño párrafo, ¿ok? So, be ready in 2 minutes. Go ahead.
Okay.
Okay, the time is over. So, do we got volunteers? Or may I choose? Let's see. Renata said, teacher, I finished. Okay, Renata, would you like to be the first one?
The first?
Yeah, the first one. Would you like to be the first one? Yes?
That's fine.
All right, perfect. And let's see, Renata, can you please help me to choose the second one? Although we have volunteer. Teacher, would you like to be the second one? 5, 4, 3. Berito, perfect. Okay, so Renata number one, Veronica number two, Aide number three. I like it. Excellent. Ladies, perfect. Okay, Renata, according to your opinion, what is the reading or the test or the paragraph about?
The text is about the our favorite animal, which is a dog. It describes how dogs are friendly, love to play, and have so far. The author enjoys taking their dog to the park to play and explain that dogs are loyal companions who are always happy to see their owners. The author loves their dog because the dogs make them happy and he's a great friend.
Excellent, thank you so much. So I listen to you like a with a very good fluency. Thank you, Renata. The second one, Berito, please go ahead.
History animal dog is friendly. She loves your dog. She always stay with your dog. I love your dog. Gain great friend.
Also happy, great, excited, talk. Finish, teacher. That's it.
That's it. Thank you so much, Berito. So nice. So, Aide, please. Ready?
Ready.
And please, I have Iván and Nayeli. Could you please help me to choose one?
Nayeli.
Okay, Nayeli, please be ready. You are the second one. Okay, Aide, go ahead.
They really talk about the best friend for the people is the dog because they are very friendly and like to play a lot, and they keep us company. Dogs make people happy. That's it.
That's it. Thank you so much. Nayeli, please. Are you ready to present?
Yes, Michelle.
Okay,
Yeah.
Mr. Ivan, be ready. You are the next one. Okay, Nayeli, what's the reading about?
The text say, "Cat dogs are playful. It makes them happy, and all the time, and they are cheerful, loyal, and very friendly. Cat dogs are good, and how he loves his dog very much."
That's it. Perfect. Thank you, Nayeli. And Mr. Ivan, are you ready to present?
Yes.
All right, perfect. Dennis, let me know if you want to try, okay? Let me know. If you don't feel comfortable, that's okay.
Okay.
Okay, Ivan, go ahead.
Well, the text is about the love that people feels about the dogs. The thing that it's energy and loyalty. That is the most important character and characteristic about them. And also, the people can be happy with a dog in their life because they are loyalty and a good company. And well, they're so happy, and especially when dogs wag their tails when someone back to home. It's good.
Yes, it is. Thank you so much, Mister. Okay. So, Dennis, would you like to participate?
Yes.
Okay, please, I'm going to finish with you. Go ahead.
His favorite animal is the dog, and he likes to take his dog to the park and play with it.
Perfect. Thank you so much. Thank you, Denise, and thanks to all of you, my dearest students. Okay, now I'm going to send to you the quiz number one. What is the quiz number one, teacher? What is about? So, quiz number one is about obviously about the text. So, how can you make sure if you understand or if you didn't doing a quiz? Okay, give us some seconds, please. I'm going to send to you into the WhatsApp. It's a short quiz, it's not a big deal, okay? All right, son las 7:58. Yo creo que a las 8:05. I think it's enough. Creo que es suficiente. Okay, students, please do the quiz if you have any question unavailable for you. Okay, now 5 minutes to do the quiz. Go ahead. Thank you, Ivan. I got your results. You got 10. Congratulations. Continue, students. You have time. No worry. You have time. Thank you, Berito. I got your results. You have 4 minutes to finish. No worries. You have time. Thank you, Aide. I have your results. You got 10. Congrats. Perfect. Tenemos 3 minutos y medio todavía. No se preocupe. Thank you, Nayeli. You got 10. Perfect. Congrats. Thank you, Denise. I got your result. You got 7. Perfect. Just Renata is missing, right? Okay. You have 1 minute. 30. Ah, okay. Perfect. Thank you, Renata. Okay. It was easy, right? Yes. Easy peasy. Lemon squeezy. Now let's continue with the next level. How to read and interpret at the same time. Level A2+. Level A2+. Look at. Level A2+ is basic on simple past. Cuando usted está aprendiendo un idioma, iba a decir inglés, pero la verdad que se aplica a todos los idiomas. Cuando usted está aprendiendo un idioma, siempre en el primer mes o en el primer módulo o en el primer nivel, como usted lo quiera llamar, siempre le van a enseñar a hablar y a leer en presente. Yo corro, yo duermo, yo estudio, yo bailo, yo cocino. Ya después, cuando íbamos subiendo de nivel, ya usted tiene que comenzar a aprender cómo decir yo comí, yo bailé, yo estudié, yo cociné. Entonces, ustedes saben perfectamente que en inglés hay dos tipos de verbos, los regulares y los irregulares. Entonces, si usted se considera que tiene la capacidad de aprender un idioma, ustedes obviamente ya están aprendiendo y practicando uno. Pero si usted se decide, digamos, teacher, yo quiero ver si aprendo un tercer idioma porque el nativo es español. Estamos ahorita con inglés y yo quisiera aprender un tercer idioma. No se exija tanto. Comience primero con lo básico, en presente. Now, when you got all the verbs in present, let's continue with the simple past. That's the level A2+. And look at the reading. The text is in past, it's not in present. So, this is one of the techniques. Esta es una de las técnicas que deberían de enseñar todos los maestros de inglés. Primero enséñale al alumno en presente, que el alumno se pueda todos los verbos en presente. Y ya después comenzamos con los verbos en pasado. Error que cometen la mayoría de colegas. Aquí están los 100 verbos, ahora apréndetelos. No. Any language is for memorize. No way. Any language is about practicing, no memorizing. Hey, you have to. Hey, you have to. It's mandatory to memorize 50 verbs for the next class. No way. Practice. But how can I practice? Easy peasy. Practice by reading. Practice by writing. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Okay, now let's continue with the next level. I'm going to read for you, and then you are going to read for me. Last weekend, I went to the beach with my family. The weather was perfect, with clear blue skies and a gentle breeze. We arrived early in the morning to find a good spot. My brother and I built a big sand castle while my parents relaxed under an umbrella. After that, we swam into the sea, which was cool and refreshing. We also had a picnic with sandwiches and fruit. In the afternoon, we took a walk along the shore, collecting seashells. It was fun and peaceful day, and I can't wait to go back. Before to start with the reading, I would like to ask you, let's see, Ivan, could you please open your microphone? Thank you so much. Ivan, can you please help me to identify? You have time, okay? No worries. You have time. Can you please, Ivan, help me to identify all the verbs in past? Go ahead. I will give you time,
Maybe.
okay? I will give you time. And then please, Aide, be ready with the same dynamic. Give and identify all the verbs, all the actions in past. Okay, Ivan, I'm going to start with you. Go ahead.
Okay, went just a bird, teacher.
Yes, just the verbs.
Went was arrived. Built. Relaxed. Built relaxed, swam, was cool, had, took, it was home, and that's it.
Perfect. Thank you so much. Well, in the first, in this second reading, it got around 8 or 9 simple past verb. Thank you, Mr. Aide. You ready to participate?
Yes, teacher.
Did you identify the simple past verb?
Went,
Okay,
was,
wait. Okay, let's.
arrived.
Okay, wait. Okay, now please,
Okay.
Nayeli, you are going to be the third one, okay? Be ready to identify the simple past verb. Now, yes, okay, Aide, go ahead.
Went, was, arrived, find, spot. Wilt, relax, one, had, took, walk, and wait, I think so.
No, and wait, but wait is in simple present. Is a verb?
Okay,
Yes.
sorry. Apuesta walk,
Okay,
walk.
yeah. Wait, it's a verb, but it is in simple present. But in that way, it is in simple present. Thank you, Aide.
Okay.
Nayeli, I'm gonna finish this dynamic with you, please. Could you help me, please, Nayeli, to
Yes,
identify
teacher.
the simple past verbs? Go ahead.
Okay. Went, was, arrived,
Arrived.
arrived, find, built, and built,
Creo que sí.
Field.
Swam was had short and was.
Okay, that's it.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, perfect. Thank you, princess. Okay, now let's see. Who was it? Renata, could you please help me to read the text? And then you are going to participate, students, the same as we did some minutes ago. You're going to tell me what's the reading about, okay? So Renata is going to read to all of you, and you are going to be ready to present what's the text about. Thank you, Renata. Go ahead, please.
Dice, repítame, por favor.
Yeah, just read the text. Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. Last weekend, I went to the beach with my family. The weather was perfect, with clear blue skies and a gentle breeze. We arrived early in the morning to find a good spot. My brother and I bought a big sand castle.
Castle.
While my parents relaxed under an umbrella. After that, we swam in the sea, which was cool and refreshing. We also had a picnic with sandwiches and bread. In the afternoon, we took a walk along the shore, collecting
Seashells.
seashells. It was a fun and peaceful day, and I can't wait to go
I
back.
can't wait to go back. Okay. Hey, there are some tricky words when it got three syllables, for example. How can I pronounce that word? Look at my cursor. How can I pronounce it? Nobody, yes, how can I pronounce it? Look at my cursor.
Yes.
Yeah, how can I pronounce? Could you please, someone, pronounce the word that I'm pointing out with my cursor?
Refreshing.
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 Refreshing. What about that one? This is a tricky word too, because it has three syllables. Cuando las palabras tienen tres sílabos, como que nos cuesta un poquito. ¿Quién me ayuda con esta? ¿O Aide? No sé, ¿hay voluntarios?
Peaceful.
Faithful.
Peaceful. Peaceful. Ok. Peaceful.
Peaceful.
Había otra tricky, no me acuerdo dónde es. Ah, esta. ¿Me ayudan, porfa?
Sandcastle.
Sandcastle.
Sandcastle. Ok, sandcastle. Ok. Okay, creo que solamente eran esas, pero siempre que hay palabras de tres sílabas, como que les cuesta un poquito a los alumnos. Ok, 2 minutes to be ready to present what the reading is about, and then obviously I have a second quiz for you. Okay, please, students, be ready in 2 minutes to tell me, teacher, this is my opinion, and this is what I got it from the test. This is the test. What is the test about? Okay, 2 minutes to be ready. 30 seconds. If someone is ready, raise your hands up. Nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Okay, could you please, Berito, are you ready to present?
Yes, teacher,
Okay, that's nice. I love it. So who wants to be the second one? Deni, Aide, Ivan, Nayeli, Renata, who wants to be? Nayeli. Excellent. So, Berito number one, Nayeli number two, Dennis number three, Aide number four. I have four volunteers. Perfect. I love it. Significa que entienden es el nivel que estamos viendo, que es el nivel A2 plus. Eso es muy bueno. El grupo que tuve anteriormente, que va al mismo nivel de ustedes, lo chistoso fue que entendieron más el B1. Y fue como un poco más tricky en la 2, quizás porque estaba en pasado. Ahora bien, antes de comenzar, para esta práctica que van a presentar ahorita, necesito que traten la manera de explicar en pasado. ¿Ok? Porque en presente es fácil. ¿Cómo hacía en pasado? So, the reading was. ¿Ok? The reading was about. O sea, vamos, tratemos de hablarlo en pasado. ¿Ok? But if you have some details about it, do it by yourself. That's okay. The most important is to get it. Okay. Aquí lo importante es que entienda y que sepa decir de qué trata. Okay. But will be much better if you explain to us in simple past. Okay, Berito, go ahead, please.
The paragraph is short. Reading is about what was last weekend they went to the beach. Your family was the weather perfect? Your brother bullied big
Castle.
Was they also had eat sandwich and fruit in the afternoon? They was work along the shore collection. That's it, teacher.
That's it. Thank you, Berito. Nayeli, you are the second one, right?
Yes, teacher.
Please. Go ahead.
The text was about his weekend vacation. He said Harrison, the weekend he went out to the beach with his family. The weather was perfect, and he did many activities with his family in the afternoon and was very relaxed because they have a picnic. Harrison.
That is all. Thank you, my dears. So, Dennis, please go ahead. And the next one is Aide. Okay, Dennis, please.
Okay. They went to the beach on a weekend, I think. It was a perfect day. Eat sandwich and fruit in the afternoon. Finished, teacher?
So I was talking with my microphone. It was off. Sorry, I'm so sorry. Nice. So excellent. Thank you, Dennis. Tenía apagado el micrófono y estaba hablando. Okay. I think. Go ahead, please.
The reading talk about a family. The last weekend, they went to the beach. Side the family was a perfect day. They arrived early. and the children built a sandcastle. After they swam in the sea. Also, they ate sandwich and read. And they was perfect day. That's it.
Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Okay, thank you so
Easy
much.
peasy.
Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Okay, thank you. Let's see, I day you're finished. And Nayeli, Renata, I think you're missing, yes or no? And Mr. Ivan?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, so Princess, you're going to be the next one. And Ivan, I'm going to finish this dynamic with you. Yes, Renata, are you ready to present?
Oh, sorry, yes.
Renata, bien distraída, te he visto, no literal, te he visto hoy. Yo creo que comiste muchos dulces en el Día del Niño.
Tal vez, teacher.
Okay, Renata, go ahead.
They really describe a family day at the beach. Then go get perfect. Water, pool, sandcastle, swan, had a picnic, and collect seashells. The narrator found it fun and looked forward to returning. That's it.
That's it. And that's perfect, Mr. Ivan. I'm going to finish with you.
Okay, well, the paragraph talk about a trip to the beach that they have to the beach and all the things that they did, like build a sandcastle, ate sandwiches and food, and walk along the shore collecting seashells, and he was excited about he was excited to back again.
All right, perfect. Thank you. So now let's continue with the final quiz. I have only two quizzes, okay? No worries. I have a message. You don't like sweets? Well, it depends. In my case, I love chocolate. It's the only sweet that I really, really, really like it. Yeah, but sweets in general, cakes, no. Lollipops, no. I just love chocolate. Okay, now please be ready with the last quiz for today. And this is quiz number two. Give us some seconds to your teacher, please. Give us some seconds. I'm going to send to you all of you into WhatsApp. Now you got it. And you have 5 minutes to complete it, okay? You have 5 minutes to complete it. Go ahead. Thank you, Ivan. I got results. You got 8. Perfect. Thank you, Nayeli. I got your result. You got 8. Perfect. Thank you, Aide. I got your results. You got 9. Perfect. Thank you, Renata. You got 8. Perfect. And I got confused, but there is an extra quiz for level B1. Yeah, there is an extra quiz. Well, let me check it out. I think it's the. It is an extra. Yeah, no, it is an extra. No, that's the last one. Yeah, that's the last one. Thank you, Dennis. Perfect. Was 6. Nice. Who's missing? Berito. Okay, perfect. Thank you, Berito. 1, 2, 3, 4. 3, 6. Perfect. Okay, thank you. Could you please, Aide, open your microphone? And please. Nayeli, be ready with the same question. Aide, when you read an article, when you read a magazine, or when you read a newspaper, or when you read online, when you read, what do you like to read?
I like to read, como se dice, variado.
Many things. I like to read about everything.
I like to read about everything. Trip, Paris, travel. I like to read everything in past, present, and future.
Okay, perfect. Thank
or
you.
Ending.
So all right. And what about the readings? From reading one, or do you prefer reading number two?
Two.
Why?
Because the talk in past.
Okay, perfect. Thank you. Nayeli, could you please open your microphone?
Yes, teacher.
What's your favorite topic to read?
I read many type of genres, but I have favorite author like how James, William, Fyodor.
Okay.
I usually read online because they are more accessible.
And that it was my third question. I want to ask you, what do you prefer, physical or online? Thank you so much, Nayeli. Could you please, Nayeli,
But
tell me, yes. Yeah, anything else? Yes, Nayeli? No?
yes, teacher. See,
Okay,
yes,
good.
I
All right,
decided.
perfect. Could you please, Nayeli, help me to read the final reading, please? Help me to read. The benefits of learning a second language. Go ahead, Nayeli.
Okay. The benefit of learning a second language. In today's globalizing world, learning a second language has become increasingly important. Not only does it improve communication skills, but it also opens doors to new cultures and opportunities. Studies have slow had language lingual people often have better problem solving ability and more creative thinking. Moreover, being able to speak another language can enrich their prosperity as many employers look for candidates who can interact with international clients. Additionally, it can make traveling more enjoyable as understanding the local language helps in navigating a new place and making connection with people. Overall, learning a second language provides both personal and professional as well language make it a valued skill to develop.
To develop. There is a detail again. Could you please look at, can you see my cursor, Nayeli?
Yes, teacher.
Could you please repeat that word? Repeat it again, please.
At being at the baggage.
Repeat, advantages.
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 Excellent. Thank you. Ventajas, advantages. And could you please repeat that one? Additionality. Additionality.
Additionality.
Okay. And that one, please. Could you please read it again?
Opportunities.
Opportunities. Perfect. And the last one, that one. Could you get my cursor? My cursor. Could you please read it again?
Increasingly.
Increasingly. Okay. Nayeli, choose one student from the list. Valuable.
Okay. Let
Deval
me
excuse
see.
me. Excuse me. Aide has a question. Yes, Aide, open your microphone, please.
Okay. How do you say the pronoun?
How pronounce?
Yes.
I'm looking for the word. Valuable, 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 valuable. Is it line
Finish.
one? Line two,
Valuable. Making it available. No sé cómo me dice.
line three,
Al
line,
final.
the last one.
Behind.
I cannot find it. My goodness, could you please help me to look it for?
En la última línea, making
Ah, so advantages, making it available skills to develop. There are two options to
valuable.
pronounce. There are two options to pronounce.
Valuable.
Yes, British and American, but in this case, valuable. Valuable.
Valuable. Okay.
Va, y exacto. No puedo decir bailable porque ya estaría siendo yo como baila, como de available, como cuando algo está disponible. Entonces, nos vamos con la parte de Valuable. Valuable. Excellent. Yes.
Valuable.
Tenemos, creo, si no, yo creo que si me equivoco son
Valuable.
tres sílabas, creo yo. Sí, son tres sílabas. So, casi siempre tenemos ese detallito con las con palabras de tres sílabas. Yo creo que voy a ver si les saco un listado de palabras de, no, es más, acuérdenme de traerles un listado el jueves de palabras con tres sílabas para que las podamos practicar. Nayeli, ¿me vas a ayudar a elegir a alguien que leyera again la última vez? ¿O lo elijo yo o tengo voluntarios?
Denis.
Thank you so much. I got a message. Let's see, I got a message. Ah, yes, I got it. Yes. Okay. Okay, Dennis, please. Could you help us to read again? Go ahead.
And today's ¿cómo se
Globalize.
dice? Globalize World. Learning a second language has become
Increasingly.
increasingly important. Not only does it
Improve.
improve communication skills, but it also opens doors to new cultures and no sé cómo se dijera eso.
To new cultures and opportunities.
Opportunities, studies.
Studies, excellent.
How show that
Bilingual.
bilingual people often how better problem
Problem solving, yes.
solving
Abilities.
abilities in more
Creative
creating
thinking.
think.
Moreover,
Moreover, being able to speak another language can answer
enhance
enhance
career.
career prospects. As many
Employers.
employers look for
Candidates.
candidate who can
Interact.
interact with international
Clients.
clients
Additionally,
additionally, it can make traveling more ¿cómo será esa?
traveling more enjoyable.
Enjoyable as understanding. Understand.
Understanding.
The local language helps in
Navigating.
navigating new place and making connections with people.
Overall,
Overall, learning a second language
provide
provides both personal and
professional
professional
advantage. Advantages.
advantages making
Advantages.
advantages advantages making it a
Valuable.
valuable
Valuable.
skill to developed
Developed.
developed.
Excellent, thank you so much. Yes, thank you, Dennis. Yes, it is. He's around 13 or 14. Yeah, 13 or 14 years old. He's trying to learn. Yes, thank you. And he's a little boy. Yeah, he is. But he's 13 or 14. Okay, thank you so much, Dennis. Okay, my dearest students. The last one is, you are going to present not to me. No me van a presentar a mí. You are going to present to your partners. I'm going to make couples. And now you're going to be the teacher. For example, supongamos que Aide se va con Iván. Iván va a tener que explicarle a Aide de qué trata este último texto. Aide, usted lo va a calificar. Vamos del 4 al 10. Después viene Aide y le presenta y le dice, bueno, ahora yo te voy a hablar de qué trata la última lectura. Iván será en este caso el teacher. Pero sí quiero que sean sinceros, porque yo ya me puedo el nivel que ustedes tienen, sé más o menos cuáles son sus debilidades, cuáles son sus fortalezas, perdón. Yo quiero que usted me diga, por ejemplo, teacher, yo considero que Iván tiene que mejorar esto, esto, esto. O Iván me puede decir, teacher, yo considero que Aide lo que tiene que mejorar es esto, esto y eso. No es sacar los errores, sino que mejorar esa parte en la que nosotros podemos estar fallando. Y con eso, obviamente, ya terminamos. ¿Alguna duda o consulta, señores? Ok, señores, perfecto. Regálame un par de segundos en lo que formo las parejas. Ok, chicos, 5 minutos. Ingresemos a sus salas, por favor.
Teacher.
Espérame, ahorita voy a ver si te puedo. Ah, sí, ahorita te agrego, ¿ok? Ahí.
Ay.
Ay. Bueno.
Hello, finished.
Oh.
So,
Yes,
más o menos, teacher.
más o menos. Ok, vamos a ver. Sala 1, tengo a Iván y Nayeli. Iván, Nayeli, open your microphones. Be ready, Dennis and Renata. Ok, so let's start with you, Nayeli. How was
Okay.
Iván's presentation for you? It was good. It was nice. It was
No la
a
había
little bit.
terminado.
You didn't finish?
No.
Yeah, but according to you, because you have been in the class with him with almost 5 or 6 months. So, what about you? What do you consider Ivan needs to improve? His confidence, his speaking, his listening.
Let me
Well,
see.
I will give you some seconds. Yeah, think about it. Ivan, what about you?
Yeah.
How was Nayeli's presentation? Yeah, tell me, be honest.
Es que me sacó, entonces ya no lo pude escuchar a gusto.
But how much
Fue
time did
cuando
you
se me
hear?
desconectó
But tell me in general, okay? In general,
el
according to you, because you have been studying almost for 5 months, I think. So, but according to you, because this is not the first time you were with Nayeli, right?
Yes.
So, according to you, what does he need to improve?
I don't know, maybe a little bit, ay, teacher, la fluidez
Definitely.
de fluency, Yes, that
And your
I
score
think.
for her from 1 to 10?
Well, 8.
Okay. Hey, that's a good score. Okay, you're a good friend. Now let me ask you, what about you, Nayeli? From 1 to 10, according to you, what's Ivan's level?
For me, 9.
Hey, listen
He
to.
improved very nice. He's very confident when he's speaking. And he pronounced the good, but the sometimes somewhat the short as worse.
Yes, Ivan, that's true. Ivan, when we ask you a question,
Sorry.
you need to give us more, okay? But Ivan likes to give short answers. I don't know why. Why, Ivan?
Soy un hombre de pocas palabras.
Okay, thank you. Next. Okay, yeah, thank you guys. Let's continue with Renata and Dennis, the teenagers. Renata, ¿cómo nos fue? Good, nice, excellent.
I think it's good.
Soso, Dennis says soso. So, what do you consider is Dennis' level, Renata, from 1 to 10?
I think it's good. I just need to improve the pronunciation of some words. It's fluency and what this I will be able to do it better. So I think I give a 7.
That's okay, you give a 7. That's a good score. Dennis, what about you? From what to
she
10, Renata?
Oh, okay. She went to improve the pronunciation in the other very and the other very well.
The rest. Okay, so the score is from 1 to 10.
And see another oh
Zero.
other very well.
Yeah, and the
Oh.
score from 1 to 10? Renata said you got 7. What about you? What's Renata's score from 1 to 10?
Eight.
Eight. Excellent. Hey, listen to Renata. Congratulations. Thank you, teenagers. Thank you so much, my juniors. Okay, and the last one is Aide and Berito. Berito, what about, how was Aide? Oops, Berito.
Sorry. Are you
sleeping?
No, the microphone.
Okay,
For me, Miss Aide, very, very good pronunciation, excellent, and also very sweet, my teacher.
Ah, wow, that's nice. And the school?
No. Teacher English.
Hey, are you ready to be an English teacher, Aide? Hey, I said it.
No.
Yeah,
I think can.
Yeah, for the next promotion. Yeah, of course, for the next promotion, of course.
Excellent.
So you don't have a score, Aide, because you are an English teacher. That's nice. Wow.
No.
the top. Now, what about you, Aide? How was Berito?
I am happy with the progress she has made.
Oh, yes.
With reading, she just lacked fluency.
Yes, a lot. Excellent.
Sorry for the score. It's 7.
It's 7. No, that's a good score. That's a good score. And that's a good score to all of you students. Okay. So,
she understands the lecture.
Yes.
A lot.
Berito tiene la capacidad de entender todas las lecturas que usted le pone.
Yeah.
A Berito lo que le falta es practicar la fluidez. ¿Y cómo practicaría la fluidez, Berito? Todos los días aprendan palabras nuevas, todos los días aprendan palabras nuevas, todos los días aprendan palabras nuevas. Porque, o sea, si no aprenden palabras nuevas, no van a poder estructurar una oración. Señores, qué excelente estuvieron el día de ahora. Si Dios no los permite, nos vemos el día jueves, siempre a las 7:30. Voy a tratar la manera de sacarles palabras con 3 sílabas para que practiquemos antes de iniciar la clase. Un poquito de pronunciación, ¿ok? Señores, fue un placer. Pasen una excelente noche. Más tardecito les mando la clase grabada. People, have a beautiful night and see you on Thursday. Bye.
Thank you.
Have a beautiful night.
Good night, teacher.
Good night. Bye.